Thank you, Marcelio. All right, so let me describe myself because I believe there are people only listening and this is being reproduced. So my audio description is that I'm a white woman with short hair. I wear glasses. I'm wearing an orange jacket in homage of Sensedia, black trousers and sneakers. I'm about 1.60 meters tall and I'm 53 years old. So it's a pleasure to be here. I have started my journey about 3 years ago at Natura, 3 years and 4 months, just a few weeks before COVID. So that was a huge challenge. So I joined a new company, a company that was also acquiring other companies. There was this huge acquisition from Avon. Everyone was kind of moving to the metaverse, working from home. So we also had a huge challenge to offer assets and new paths for the beauty consultants. So today at Natura, we have 2,100,000 consultants, and at Avon, about 2 million representatives. So we have in total 4.1 beauty consultants and representatives in Latin America. And they were all at home, and so they could not leave and go to the streets in the direct sales model. So infrastructure and digital infrastructure, digital architecture, there was a lot of work to be done to bring solutions and accelerate the digitization of these entrepreneur women's journey. So to start, I would like to play a video to talk a little bit about Natura, to present the company to those who do not know it, because afterwards I'm going to talk a little bit about the stories, and it's interesting for you to understand a little bit about the business, because after all, there's no technology if we are not talking about business. Technology for itself alone is not really that important. So let's see the video.
Full of big companies.
Nós também somos grandes.
3,200 stores.
6.3 million representatives.
E consultoras.
Bringing our products to over 200
million customers.
Em 100 países.
Mas por que nosso tamanho importa?
Aren't there bigger things to be worrying about?
Le monde n'a pas besoin d'une autre grosse entreprise.
Anita Wadek's hanging around Gongguo.
Those words are as true today as they were then.
The world deserves something more.
Nós acreditamos que podemos promover impacto positivo.
We believe that the merit of originality
is not novelty, it is sincerity.
We stand for her and promise to build a better world for women through women.
And we believe business can be a force for good.
Somos grandes y por eso tenemos una responsabilidad importante.
And that's doing business.
Not to be the best in the world, but to be the best for the world.
We need to be so much more than just another big company.
We are
innovators.
Change creators.
A company of women
for women.
Nós compartilhamos riqueza.
Planet carers.
Rainforest protectors.
And we'll never be animal testers.
Natura.
The Body Shop.
Aesop.
Natura and Co.
The best beauty group for the world.
So this video represents Natura globally, so it represents LATAM. In Latin America, we have all four brands, and globally, we have presence in several countries. But that is just to give you an idea about the group Natura & Co. And the Co is commercial, but it also talks about Eco, which is the sustainability flag at the company. All right, so what do we have here? So in Latin America, these are some of the figures. We are present in 18 countries. We have over 900 stores, retail stores, Natura and The Body Shop. There are 2 million hectares of the Amazon forest preserved with all our actions, 4.1 million consultants and representatives, as I have mentioned already, and over 16,000 employees. Last year, we generated 22 billion Brazilian reals in net revenues. When we talk about technology, this is an analogy that I like to use. Those of you, who is more technical here, show of hands. So most of you, okay. Who deals more with business? Who is on the business side? There you go, a lot of people as well. So my background is technical, but I'm not an expert. But Paulo, I listen to my architects, yeah? Breno is probably also in the audience. I'm not sure if he's here. I'm not sure if he arrived on time. But I listen to my architects. And this is an analogy of the human body and technology. So technology is always imitating nature. And just like our peripheral and central nervous systems, we have the peripheral nervous system delivering information. So that's an analogy with APIs. We are all the time dealing with business rules, distributing stimuli, and executing actions. So it's basically what we're living, you know, where we have a lot of solutions distributed everywhere, and how do we connect all of that? So this is an analogy of together with our nervous system. So when we talk about APIs are, for me, different doors that are interconnected and expand possibilities. We have been living in this hyper-connected world for a while now. And if it were not for APIs, we would take a long time to get to the same results. So these are doors that are interconnected and expand the possibilities that we have in this business world that we live in. And when we talk about the beauty consultants, their journey actually started door by door. So it was basically the ding-dong of the consultants. And APIs actually opened several doors. And I would like to show you some of the business cases that we have where we use APIs. And so new doors were opened and accelerated that type of business. And obviously, there was an impact in productivity of these consultants. So in numbers, we have over 300 APIs at Natura. And the number does not mean a lot to me because, as Paula mentioned, we have to think about the reusability. So I could have 1 trillion APIs, but they have to do different things, right? So we talk about a sustainable world. And in order to be sustainable, we cannot repeat the number of assets in the company to do the same things. We have to pay attention to that and be able to reuse them. So we have an average of 200 accesses per month to our API portal. We do the governance there, and we help with that reusability. And per month, we have over 5 billion API calls. So that's a lot. So you see there's a lot of reusage of APIs. On average, we deploy 1.6. We have 1.6 deploys in the company. And we also have a new business that was not shown on the video because last year we launched the Natura Co Pay, which is a Natura bank. And in less than a year, we have over 600,000 accounts, and we provide also financial services, and we will launch that, all of that connected through APIs. Right, so let's talk a little bit about our portal. We have the developers portal, so it's a collaborative portal that promotes the reusage. It's a single repository of documentation, because, you know, or else you will have APIs being born everywhere. I'm not sure if you know Lady Conway. So whenever you want assets according to your organizational structure, sometimes you want to distribute a lot, and you have, you know, technologists and experts, and technologists are also developing things, although they're not experts, and you start, you know, having duplicities and things that are not that sustainable. So this portal is also an accelerator so that we're not, you know, reinventing the wheel, so to speak. And we also, you know, have to talk about modernization, because there's a huge potential there to understand the behavior of the APIs. And today we do not monetize anything. We do not create any new products through APIs, but we have several studies going on in order to be able to explore those paths. We also have a Sensedia portal where we have the monitoring of APIs. We conduct performance analysis and governance. There is also version management, scalability, and safety. Safety is really a key topic. So when we talk about solutions, depending on where you're connected, with whom you're connected, you might put your whole business and reputation at risk. So it's really, really important. That, not speaking about, you know, the hack attacks that we all suffer every day. Right, so this slide is about cases of acceleration. So API means the accelerator of prosperity and integration for us. So first of all, talking about beauty consultants. So beauty consultants have their business, they are entrepreneurs. And within that direct sales models, today we also have digital magazines. So they help us, they help the consultants to scale their business, because they are able to send that via SMS or email. And that also helps reduce printing costs. So this can go to their app. They can have the management of their business, all of that through digital systems, applications connected via APIs. Yesterday, there was a live shopping event, and that was all connected with the digital magazine using APIs. Regarding training, training is another important chapter for us. We conduct a lot of training so that the consultants have more productivity in their business, and so that they also get more education regarding digitization and financial knowledge as well. So financial education is paramount for these consultants, and there are training platforms that we develop. There are also platforms that we acquire, and there are platforms that the consultants create themselves. We have consultants that are also trainers and get paid for that, and all of that is also connected through the through APIs in the consultant portal. We also work with gamification. So there are growth plans. There are several levels in the direct sales model, and that exists to engage, to empower, and to generate more revenue using APIs. In finance, we have Natura and Avon Pay. So within the app, besides, you know, the regular banking service, like generating payment links or, you know, you are also able to make payments in installments for the customer. So there are several services there in the app. And there's also the financial education part within that bank app. The virtual assistant is also regarding the operations. So we have Nat at Natura and Bella at Avon. The virtual assistants basically work with orders, credit card statements. So it's a basically a customer service, order tracking service. And all of that happens via WhatsApp. And basically, what is the nervous system again? APIs.
We also have a delivery app. You can pretty much choose a store, so you can pick up your products from a store. And we have other delivery options that we have been exploring using APIs to accelerate this process. And we have other partners. So I don't know if you know about Singu, but I call it the Uber for beauty products or for beauty services. You can pretty much book a massage or a manicure. You'll find a catalog of different professionals, and they are also Natura sales reps or consultants, and vice versa. Some of our consultants also become a single professional. So we have acquired this business, and with that we can accelerate the crossing between the businesses to increase the productivity of our beauty consultants through APIs. So these are the different cases, but when we start talking or going back to talk about business, because again, we don't have technology without impact. At Natura, we control the all our profits and losses. We control the social and environmental impact that they generate. So for every one real in revenue, Natura generates 2.7 reals of positive social environmental impact. And this is very inspiring. It creates purpose because, again, people are building technology, but behind the technology, we also have this incredible impact that our business can generate. And the Human Development Index from the Natura consultants, so the Human Development Indexes is part of the IP&L or the integrated P&L that we have. And from a scale that goes from 0 to 1, we are at 0.6, which has been the best result for the past 10 years. So this is another measure that we own. And we also have another figure here, another measure. And we see that as soon as consultants, they join their network, their quality of life immediately improves. So we have had more than 24% in the evolution of this HDI index with a focus on financial education. So the training platform, whether it's through banking or the consultant app, there has been an improvement of 24% on the Natura HDI number through financial education. A 7% increase has happened over digital inclusion. And this was highly accelerated by the pandemic because many consultants were not used to the digital world and they needed to catch up and improve their skills in order to survive and make a living. So with that, we have this other metric that has been increased year over year in terms of digital inclusion. And 34% of our consultants, or actually 34% of the income that these women have come from their beauty consultant services. So it also has a great impact on their families. And 44% of them say that the money that they make can actually last until the end of the month. So we are really contributing to the economic impact of their lives. And in conclusion, just some final thoughts. First, we are living this moment now, this accelerated pace of change, so many possibilities, and sometimes there's so much noise, there's so many things going on that we don't really know exactly where to get started. And in this era of platforms and ecosystems, we need to establish simpler connections. We cannot keep reinventing the wheel and trying to do everything from scratch like we used to a couple of years ago. APIs are the essential enabler to accelerate businesses and partnerships in this new world of ecosystems. And we need to learn or know with whom we are making business to ensure the safety of APIs. And that includes our gateway partners. It includes the API itself, because we use an external partner or we consume APIs from different companies. So it is extremely important to know with whom we are dealing, if there are no biased interest, because again, we are living the world of open API, so we need to really know what's happening. Okay, this is open, but is there any really hidden interest behind this? So it is very important to know this when you're not developing your API, when you're just consuming an external API. It's important to know to whom you're connecting. Adaptive governance and reusability by design. So from the get-go, you have to learn or know how to reuse that API. So it's not really specific for one topic that wouldn't allow you to reuse it. An API is a living asset. API is a living asset in the company because it evolves. Technology also evolves. So how can we see this as a living asset, constantly revisiting it to see if we do have more possibilities to increase its potential? And of course, we have to look at how we can monetize it. So how can we transform that asset into a new business, perhaps? And in conclusion, it can only be called innovation if it generates a positive impact to society and to the planet. And I'm certain that this room filled with people is not only generating innovation and impact to the world. Sometimes you don't know about the impact that you generate, but just stop and think how much of that you design and think can generate an impact, because again, without the impact, it cannot be called innovation. And before, I think we have some time for questions, right? But before that, I just wanted to show you this QR code. Well, of course, I want to ask for your feedback and see if you have any ideas for our company. You learned a little bit about the Natura business, you know why we are using APIs for, if you, I don't know, thought of something that you would like to share with us, please feel free to do so, because we are as good as the things that we share. And this will be a gift for us. Feedback is an act of love, so if you can show us your love, that would be incredible. I'll leave it on the screen for a couple of seconds. And last but not least, of course, I have to promote myself too. This is a link to my LinkedIn account. We have a lot of movements focused on women. I know the tech world is not really an area with a lot of women, but I'm really active in that purpose. So make sure you stay tuned to my LinkedIn for more of that. Thank you very much. Thank you for your attention. And if you have questions, I'm available. Thank you, Ren. Well, of course, it's easy for me to say because I think, like most Brazilians, I'm a huge fan of the brand. We have time for two questions. I have my question ready for you, and here it goes. One of your first challenges, the first challenges that you talked about were related to integration. And we have technology integration between Natura and Avon, and then you have products and technology. I would like for you to talk a little bit about the difficulties on each type of integration. And what is the result of that after 2 years? Do we have 2 hours for me to answer this? Well, the main difficulty is integration. Because again, system integration, API integration, what's difficult is the legacy, right? When you have a new company and a startup, integrating, it's easy. But when you have hundreds of systems, to integrate legacy systems, it's difficult because not always you have technology that is enabled for the integration. So that's a little bit of the difficulty. You asked about system, processes, and people. Oh, no, products. Okay. Well, digital products, right? Well, speaking of digital products, I think the main difficulty had to do with ways of working, believe it or not. So the way we work, I think many organizations, they have a team structure that is more traditional, so to speak. And at Natura, we have started this journey some time ago. We are focused on products, but we always see this challenge because sometimes it's a little bit of a black and white cookie, half and half, you know? So org design is always in its beta version. It's a living thing. You have to constantly learn and constantly adapt to it. And sometimes we are not really comfortable with change as people. So sometimes we should be more agile in changing the way we work and the way we organize our teams. And that has to do with products. So from the design of the product or how we come up with a purpose for the product to how we build, deliver, and activate the product. Because another topic that many times is a challenge is that sometimes some products, they just sit on the shelf. They are not activated by their market. Or if they are, the turnover is too high. And again, people is what make a company, right? So then the owner of that product that was constantly using it eventually leaves and the product is left fatherless. So it has to do with different team structures, the way we work, and that has to do with people. So as people, I think we need to have this mindset. We need to have this mindset of frozen, just let it go. We want to have command and control, and that's not going to happen. You need to have that ownership, sense of ownership. You want to do what's best for the big team and with this mission in mind. I think this is the mindset that people need to have, this sense of ownership. I imagine that for a company that has such a clear culture like Natura, any people integration is always going to be a challenge. We had a panel before with Cielo, Aza, and Sicred talking about innovation, and half of the conversation was about people culture. We have time for one question from the audience. We have microphones. You need to use the microphone, so we have translation. Just raise your hand if you have a question, and the microphone will be taken to you. There were two things about your final messages that I loved, which is seeing APIs as an asset, because we talked about this. And today you talked about adaptive governance. Today we recorded a podcast. Myself, Silvia Bassi, and the CIO from Maggi Insurances. So we talked for 1 hour about adaptive governance. So we do have some content on that. And the good news is that we have a bunch of APIs, and the bad news is that we have a bunch of APIs. So we talked about that and having a more adaptive governance. So if you were in the sessions, you didn't listen to the podcast. If you were at home, I'm sure you've listened to it, but it's available anyway. Hi, I'm Silva Coelho. I'm CTO at Farum Hub, a startup, and I've created a movement called They Code, Women Code, and I'm very proud to listen to you. And I wanted to hear perhaps a tip or a suggestion for young women and also young men, because the world is evolving so fast. And thinking about your career evolution, regardless of technology, AI, or any tech innovation, what would be the most important thing for young women and young men to reach a place like you? I'm calling you by your name because I feel very close to you. Yeah, of course, I'm a grandma, but you don't have to call me ma'am, don't worry. Sylvia, that's your name, right? Nice to meet you, Sylvia, and thank you for your question. Well, first, I think for young people, this new generation, I have two daughters, one is 24, the other is 27, and it's a little bit of that. They're so anxious. And I'm sure, who is 24 and 27 in the room? Yeah, we do have some people. So, kids, hear me out. No, first, I mean, calm down a little bit. And second, you own your careers. You own your careers. No one, not the company, not anyone else. It's you. You have to know where you want to go, and you need to work for that. Continuously learning. Be humble to know that you don't know everything. So learn. And the other thing is you need to understand what is the problem that you're trying to solve. Because many times, especially in technology, we are so passionate about technology, but sometimes we don't think about how we can apply technology to solve a real problem. So it's important to understand the problem. You need to be humble and willing to learn. You need to be patient to listen, because sometimes you don't stop and listen. And cooperation. I think we live in a highly connected world. And when you cooperate, when you listen to others, you learn faster. So I think this is the main thing. Be humble, work together, and own your career. Yes, your career belongs to you. Thank you very much. I'm a fan.